Good morning, all of you. I wish you a pleasant day for all of you. And today we are going to discuss about structure of a sea. Yesterday we had discussed about the life of a plant and how does it grow, growing from leaf, stem, roots, and even from seeds. Today we are going to deal about structure of a sea structure. If you observe a soft seed carefully, you can view the outer seed coat just as a people wear coat of protection from bad weather. Seed coat provide protection from the seed against entry of germs, injury, harsh weather conditions. Structure of a seed coat, there is an outer coat just like what humans use. We used to have this kind of coat in the winter, isn't it? In order to escape from fever, cold, cough, etc. At the same time, the seeds also have a kind of coat to protect from germs, to protect from injury, to protect from harsh weather. So seeds also have a seed coat. On one side of the seed, you will find a scar called hilum, which shows the point of attachment of the seed to the fruit. On the top of the hilum, there is a small hole through which water enters the seed and it swells up. See, there is a small seed coat is already here. Then what is cotyledon? This is called cotyledon. Okay, this is called cotyledon. This part is called cotyledon. And hilum, see this point, this particular point is hilum. Then root, see how it comes up. One of the seed, you can find a scar called hilum, which shows the point of attempt to the fruit. Now remove the seed coat. See, once you soak it, once you put a seed in the water, maybe after one day, you can just do it. You can find the developments which comes in the seed, isn't it? Inside the seed coat, you will see one or two fleshy seed leaves. These fleshy seed leaves are called cotyledon. Okay, inside of seed coat, you can find two fleshy leaves. These fleshy leaves is always called cotyledon. The cotyledon store food for the baby plant and the embryo for its early stages growth. So this which helps to the plant in the early stage of growth. Okay, this cotyledon stores food. This cotyledon always store food to the baby plant to grow in the early stage of growth. Got it? Cotyledon also protect the embryo. The closer look, the baby plant shows tiny leaves on the root. This makes the beginning of a new plant. The seeds of plant like beans, peas, and pulses, which have two cotyledons, are called dicot seeds. So these are the things. These are the plant. These are the seeds which have two cotyledons. What is the use of having cotyledon? Which means the store food for the baby plants in the very beginning of their growth. Got it? At the same time, these are the seeds which have two cotyledons. Got it? Clear? And these plants are beans, okay, are called dicot seeds. While seeds of plants like rice, wheat, and maize, which have one cotyledon, are called monocot seeds. What is a monocot seeds and dicot seeds? The dicot seed had two cotyledon and the monocot seed has only one cotyledon. What is cotyledon? Which stores food for the plants to grow in the early stage. The early stage of a plant which helps to grow the plant. Got it? That's here. So there is an activity for you. Try to do this activity. And those activity will be given you later. Okay, no need to do it. Now we just focus on the chapter. Later we give the activities. Growing new plants from seeds. So let's understand which are the plants which grows from seeds. While eating fruits like apple, orange, chiku, mango, etc., you can see, find the seed and discard it as an inedible and indigestible part of a fruit. However, seeds are extremely important because they give rise to baby plant. In this condition of good sunlight, of proper warmth, appropriate water and air, the seed grows into a new baby plant or seedling. This process of growth of seed into a new plant is called germination. See? Suppose you might have seen apple, orange, chiku and mangoes. You can see the part inside of the flesh. You can find a seed. Yes, there are seeds. Chiku maybe two or three seeds will be there. Mangoes only one seed. So orange, there are many seeds. Apple also, there are some seeds inside of the flesh. Isn't it? You have found it. So this part is inedible and indigestible, which cannot be digestible. That cannot be digestible. So it is important part of a fruit. Those particular seeds can be planted in the soil to grow and reproduce another plant. It comes up, sprout another plant. Got it? Clear? This condition, good sunlight, once you plant it in the water, they can observe it. Take a seed of chiku, plant it in the soil, or dig it and plant it, keep it in the mud. And put enough water. When they started to grow, to get enough warmth, sunlight, to grow and become just like a big tree. See, this is called, these are the plants which grows always from seeds. This process is called germination. Different stages involved in germination can be studied from figure shown below. See, these are the process actually take place in a seed. The stages of germination in the bean seed. But we are talking about the beans. Seed, proper air, water and warmth. Seed swells into seed and cord burst in, burst open, give rise a new plant. See the process. First it is planted. Second it is brought up. Started. See the process which are the DEF. There are five processes. No, six processes are there. A mature plant does not show cotyledon and after shrink and disappear. Once the plant which grows up, once the plant grown up, there won't be any cotyledons. Okay, it just shrinks and disappear from it. What is the use of this cotyledon in the plant is that in the beginning stage, it stores food and helps the baby plant to grow, to help to grow. Isn't it? It always help to grow. It is only the role of that. Once it is grown up, okay, once the plant grown up, this cotyledon cannot be found in there. Got it? I think it is clear for you. The growing embryo gets food, it's from the cotyledons. However, as embryo grows into the seeding, it gets food from the soil because stored food in the cotyledon gets used up. Small pores in the soil are filled with air, which gives air to growing seedings. Once it started to grow, the cotyledon will disappear from it. And there won't be any use of them. So from where the plants get to get this kind of energy to grow? From the soil, from sunlight. Soil, isn't it? From soil, they get this food which helps them to grow. You should not sow too many seeds together or close to another. As a seedling grows in size, it needs more water, air, food, sunlight and space. So what they say, don't plant many seeds together, it close to another or close to another. Our seeding grows in size, they need water, air, sunlight and space. More space is needed. Once you kept in four or five seeds in together in the same thing, what happens when it is sprout up, when it started to grow, they need more space, they need more water, they need more sunlight, more food, air, etc. When there are many seeding growing close to another, they complete each other for their need, thus many of seedings die. So what happens? The seed, the plant which take more food can exist. And you're taking food, collecting water, collecting air, sunlight, if it is less, it will finally dies. Also, all seeds do not germinate because some seeds are eaten by birds, insects and some are destroyed by harsh weather conditions. If you plant many, but only two or three may be grown up. Rest of them may be eaten by eaten by birds, insects, and some are destroyed by the harsh weather, maybe continuous rains, maybe if there is no but drought can be affected for the seeds, so it may be spoiled or dies. Got it? It's clear for me. So now we are talking about next heading, dispersal of seeds. What do you mean by dispersal? Do you have any action, that process of destroying or spreading? Dispersal of seeds. Growing many seeds together can lead to insufficient space, water, light, air, and minerals for the growth of plants. Okay, sowing many means once you sow something in the field together can be insufficient space, water, light, air, and minerals to grow for plant. Therefore, if all the seeds produced by a plant fall under it, it causes crowded condition which may lead to death of many seeds growth. Unhealthy plant, thus mature seeds should scatter away from the parent plant to give rise to healthy new plants. What happens if you sow many plants together? There won't be any space for it. Once it grows, it may be destroyed by itself because they are not getting any minerals from it. No space for that. So the healthy plant will always grow. As plants are fixed, scattering of seeds take place with the help of agents like wind, water, and animals. The method of scattering of seeds away from the parent plant by various agents is known as seed dispersal. Got it? Generally, there are four means of seed dispersal. Let us study them in detail. There are four ways of seed dispersal. Okay? First one is dispersal by wind. Then dispersal by water, dispersal by animals, and dispersal by explosion. These are the four types of dispersal of a plant. First by wind. How? Some seeds are carried away to a new place by the wind. These seeds are they light in weight, lightweight like seeds of the orchid which are light as dust. Some seeds are hairy like seeds of dandelion and milkweed. This hair grows, act little parachutes, and they carry seeds away from one from the parent plant. These the seeds of maple and elm trees have wings, so they can also easily carried away by the wind. Dispersal wind means it move from one place to another. It moves from one side to another. Can be by wind, lightweight. Can be let's just get dust. It moves with, sometimes the seed itself have a wings to fly. So these are the things which flows according to the movement of the wind. Got it? So these are the, see the maple, hairy seeds of milkweed. You might have seen this kind of seeds. Maybe in the video or in your nearby surroundings or nearby forest area can be seen these kind of things. Got it? Can be moved by wind. Dispersal water. Through water comes fruits which float on water, as those the water lily, lotus, and coconut palm are carried away distant place by water. See how it can be carried by water. These are the plant, orchid, lily, and even coconut tree also can be moved by water. Coconut have fibers outer covering, while lotus and lily fruits have spongy part which help them to float, on water. So coconut has what kind? A fiber type outer covering, isn't it? So the lotus and lily have a spongy type. It is float on water. So dispersal water, these are the seeds. Got it? So dispersal by animals, how it comes? Some plants produce juicy fruit which attracts animal and they eat them. Animal eat the fruit and excrete the undigested seed of the fruits, which thus dispersed into different places. Blackberry, cherry, and apple seeds are dispersed in this way. Similarly, birds also like to eat fruits, and they also help to disperse the seeds and areas through their droppings. That means how it is dispersed by animals. There are some attracted plants and fruits for the animal. They used to have it digest. I mean, they used to have it. Finally, the dropping through the droppings, it comes to grow, just like blackberry, cherry, etc. Apple seeds, even apple seeds also. So the dispersal by animals and birds also happen the same. Then birds also, when the birds get attracted by some fruit, they used to have it. Then when they drop it, the particular area it may come up. So it's the dispersal by animals. So dispersal by explosion. How the dispersion come? Explosion. Some plants have pods that explode when the ripe shoots out their seeds to distant places. Pea and bean plants also keep their seeds in a pod. When seeds become ripe and pod dries, it bursts, it opens, scatter and pee the bean seeds. Once it get ripened, it scatter it. Okay, can scatter it, it comes suddenly burst out. Burst out means it has maybe break it. So the seed can spread it. So the it can grow such a way, dispersal by explosion. That's called dispersal by explosion. Some plants have pods that explode the ripe shoot on their seed distant places. That means when it grows, when it is grown up or ripened, the ripened thing may burst out. So the seeds may spread it. So this is called the dispersal of explosion. So we are going to the last part of this chapter. That is agriculture. What is agriculture? If you you get most of your food from plants, and to provide food and large population, you need to grow healthy plants on the large scale. Such plants which are grown in large scale of food, another purpose are called crops. Many cash crops, isn't it? There are many cash crops. The practice of growing crops is called agriculture. Just like you can see many of the agriculture field in and around you, and in the Kurchan itself, and many places nearby. Isn't it? In your village itself, you can find there are many agriculture fields where the cash crops grows. Such plants which are grown in a large scale for food and another purpose, just like wheat, isn't it? Rice and wheat, etc. Different crops need different climatic and soil condition. The temperature and amount of light vary according to the time of day and season of the year. There are some seasons to plant these kind of crops. Isn't it? So climate condition should be clear, and soil condition must be clear, temperature. Then it is completely depend on the nature. It's completely depend on nature. See the example of rabi crops, oats and wheat, then kharif crops, millet and rice. These are largely cultivated in agriculture. Got it? Then the farmers grow plants according to the season, suit the growth of crops. November and April like wheat and oats, and rabi crops are cabbage, cauliflower, beans, peas, and some of the vegetables grown in winter season. These are rabi crops like vegetables like cabbage, cauliflower, beans, etc. Are grown in only winter season. And this the another plant, this crops like wheat and oats, barley, etc. grown only in November and April. Okay, that's only for understanding. Then what is kharif crops means veg, pumpkin, brinjal, gourd, and also in summer season. These are planted only in summer season. So according to the season, climate change, weather, soil condition, they cultivate things. But increasing crop productivity. Why do farmers add manure and fertilizers to the soil? When crops are grown in the yield of year after year, the soil becomes poor in minerals. So the farmers do. Why do they use planting, so it may reduce, the mineral may reduce from the soil. In order to get more minerals, more growth for the plant, they use manure and fertilizers. Some of the widely used chemical fertilizers are ammonia sulfate and nitrate, etc. are used. Okay, manure is a natural fertilizer which is produced from decomposition of dried leaves, dropping of animals. These are also added for field of improving the quality and enriching minerals in the soil. And not only the fertilizers, but also the droppings of animal also been used in the soil for the improvement and the quality of the soil. Manure also can be natural fertilizer. These are called animal droppings are called a natural fertilizers. And it does not harm the animals living in the soil. So it never harms the animals who are living in the soil. Sometimes the overuse of ammonium sulfate and nitrate, which may badly affect the plants too, the animals too. Got it? Some of the important ways to improve the growth of crops and increase their production as follows. Prepare the soil well, plough. what they, how do they prepare the soil, the plough the land, loose the area, and add right kind of right amount of fertilizers on it. Usually had healthy and good variety of seeds they sow. Water the fields well, wide, and amount of water also it is important. Though this is actually about the chapter, there is nothing more, nothing less. That what we how learn and what we have, what you can see in and around you is clearly explained in this chapter. Okay, what we have seen and what we have learned, everything is we know before that. Isn't it? It is clear for you. It is clear for you and easily understand it in a simple. Why didn't even explain word by word or sentence by sentence? Just what is the content of the chapter? I think it is clear for you and easily understand. Okay. So try to read this chapter from beginning to end. So it will be easy, more understanding. You can understand more easily than a teacher explanation. Got it? It's clear for you. And try to make notes on this. Try to make at least two or three. Each headings can be make in a simple points. Take the notebooks, write the heading of the chapter. Then try to make the each heading. So heading should have subheading. Subheading can be some points. 1, 2, or 3 points can be. So it will be easy for you to understand. So every time, no need to look at the textbook. Every time, no need to follow the textbook. Whenever you need, suppose you are preparing for the exam, you just open the notebook. Oh, these are the things that I have learned. So it will be easy for you to understand. Okay. Thank you for listening to me. Have a nice day. Thank you.